Good evening, everybody out there on YouTube. I've got a big announcement for you before we get into the video today. Special announcement for all of you that have been watching the videos, even through the issues. Thank you so much. I have now solved the problem and we've got a new camera and a mic. No more audio issues. Crystal clear audio for all of our conversations and interactions with people here. I can't wait. Let's get into the video, guys. I got another great one for you. Even with some of the issues, she's a lovely person. I'm excited to introduce you to my friend Marie. She took me to a fantastic place here in Luang Prabang. If you haven't tried it, you gotta give it a try. It's called Formula B. All right, I'll see you in the video.
All right, we made it into the city on a very rainy day. Heading back to Paxay in a couple days already. I've been volunteering at the horse stable bit and going to grab some food here in the city and then go get her nails done before she goes back home and see what else we can do here in the city while we're here. Definitely some good food first. It's called Formula B. I like the sound of it. Cheesecake. After some food or before some food.
After.
I'm so hungry. I went and grabbed some stuff for breakfast this morning to cook and I don't know. The lighter on the switch is not working, so they'll take it over and get it fixed by one of these shops. Very rainy day. Crazy rain. We're here in this historic zone already. All the way from the Tai Lu village. I like the idea of that. Is there anything in particular you feel like eating, Marie? Noodles, that's usually Lao girl's favorite thing. Are you a big noodle fan? Oh, yeah. I actually know a really good place here in the city, but it's not around here. Darn it. I love everything. I just adapt to whatever everybody else wants to eat, and I put a lot of eggs inside. So if I get kalpiag, I just get lots of eggs too. Otherwise, I'm hungry so fast. Always eating. There's food down there. It's so quiet right now with the rain and the... All right. They're not open yet? They usually have good food. They're not open yet. I don't know. Let's see. We're just going to pop in here across from the night market into Hanpo. It's just right here on the street. Been in here before.
Definitely.
Get some food. I'm excited. I don't know if Marie is excited as I am.
I love to eat.
All right. Another good meal in the books. And we are now on our way to a highly recommended cheesecake spot. How many times have you had it?
Three, four times.
I thought she was about to tell us one time, but you actually have had it several times. I thought you had it one time. And all right. So I got high hopes. Cheesecake. Let's go. Formula B is the name. It's like 600 meters from the night market over there where we're at. Just straight down the main road here. It's been well over a year and a half since I've had cheesecake. Since I came to Laos, I haven't had cheesecake once. What kind of cheesecake do they have? That sounds fantastic. I'm a big fan of a New York strawberry cheesecake. We're in for a treat today. Hey, we're upstairs.
So nice, look at this place. You have coffee up here. You can have a little window view if you'd like. I'll take a look real quick. They have everything. Look at that. Butter cheesecake.
Oh, buddy.
Let's give it a go. Taste test. I just realized this.
Oops.
There you
go. Try it.
It's not jelly. It's not jellies in.
Jelly and the cheese doesn't really mix well together, but with the gravy cheese.
This coconut one is so good. Not what I expected. And totally not what I expected. Because for some reason I wasn't reading the label that didn't say cheesecake.
I was surprised. I was like, man.
Sometimes I just get filming and I'm like in my own
world.
Whoops. My bad. This is what happens. But then I try stuff that I wouldn't otherwise probably try. So. But I do want some of that cheesecake, Bob. The crust. That's good stuff. I got the cheesecake. Yeah. That's a green light on the cheesecake.
Nice, isn't it?
Very nice. All right, time to enjoy. Just all the time, you run into another little gem here. Before I'm walking. I wouldn't have found this place probably when they didn't recommend it, honestly, because it's just like, you just look inside and all you see is a little cheesecake, and you wouldn't even know that they have the cafe upstairs. So, here and there, bro, when you see a place, take a look upstairs, they might have a really nice cafe.
That was done so well. Very impressed.
This one.
To the nail shop we go. It's not raining bad right now.
I really like the architecture of the building here. It's very nice, like a mix of the colonial house and the Lao house.
Mm-hmm.
The roof and the foundation.
Oh, yeah, they moved the plane out of a bomb over there. Sorry, Lao. Luckily, most Lao people, I've not met anybody that's been upset about it with me. Everybody's been very kind in Lao, even though we did really bad things here.
Luang Kapow. What is Luang Kapow?
I've never seen anybody with the name Kapow. Have you?
Well, I've seen some people named Ling. That's the at my school.
You guys catch what that was? Because she said it with the Lao accent. Have you met anybody named Remote or Russia?
Oh, man, they're really funny Lao nicknames. Should we go through a couple of them?
My mom's friend has a son that's named COVID.
Oh, wow. That's a new one for me.
COVID.
I'm used to like, Ila Ila.
That's my mom's nickname.
So, yeah, typical Lao nicknames tend to be pretty funny, you know, like fatty, darky, blacky. I don't know how we'd even translate them into English. Skinny.
Yeah, darky and blacky out because I've seen some discords online about it. And
people get upset.
Yeah.
It's just totally different. The nicknames could be anything, really.
Silly nicknames. Basically, just based off of what are the parents, like, give them as a nickname when they're a kid.
I think that's most noticeable about you, I guess.
Yeah, what happened? You didn't get a Lao nickname.
No, just my real name is already short enough.
So she got the Mali. The Mali is the jasmine flower. And yeah, that's probably as good as it gets, really, for Lao nicknames. They usually aren't like that. It's an improvement, a step up above Remote. Anybody named TV?
I think I've seen someone named Boat.
Boat? A lot of boats. Bank. Boat.
Oh, my best friend's ex-boyfriend is named Dick.
Oh, really? I've never met anybody named Dick. They're very silly.
I guess his parents didn't like him.
His name Hum?
No, Dick.
No, really, Dick? Some people's nickname is Testicle. The nicknames are pretty funny, guys. And you think
sometimes when adults call over, I don't know, little kid mail servers or little kid, I have no money.
Yeah.
Small balls
come here. Small balls come here. It is actually something hilarious that if you want to call a server that is much younger, if I was to call one of these teenagers or 20-year-olds that were coming to serve, I could call them that. I'm not. You small ball.
Recommended here because I don't know. Yeah, but actually, it's pretty common on the lowest.
It's more of a term of endearment. I know everybody's gonna be like, "Oh my god, how would you call somebody that you don't even know?" You probably might not the first time, but as a Lao person that's older, like it's totally fine and normal, but pretty funny, right? Small balls. I'm not. We feel it all the time in Lao families too, like the aunts and uncles referring to like the little. Their little nephews always be like, I'm not, you know, like, small balls is just a term of endearment in Lao.